Hello， 大家好，欢迎回到我的 Podcast Ariel 悄悄对你说。今天呢，我特别邀请了我在加拿大一个非常好的朋友，那我们应该是认识5到10年有了吧，然后我们也是看彼此成长，然后看着他就是进来真的是约会情史非常丰富，然后回到加拿大的时候跟他聊聊，突然觉得我们好像可以把它录成 podcast， 因为他有很多非常有趣非常 juicy 的 story， 所以呢今天特别邀请到我的好朋友 Daniel Liu。
大家好，我是 Daniel， 中文名字叫做刘德坚，我是在加拿大出生的，但是我也有在台湾住一段时间。
你是什么时候去台湾住一段时间？
我大概是5岁的时候搬到台湾，然后我在台湾有读小学，好像读到3年级，然后我又回来加拿大读书，但是呢，自从好像13岁、14岁，我每一年都有回台湾去，就暑假的时候有回去玩啦，所以呢，在那边的时候就是有一点台湾的交往经验
但大部分都还是在加拿大交往经验比较多吧。
对对，是
对对，你跟我相反，我是刚好就是我到国小，对，我是国小3年级的时候搬回台湾，然后那时候是你回加拿大的时段，
好像是
国小的时候。 对啊，刚好跟你相反。But anyway， 我跟 Daniel 是，我们是高中的时候认识的吗？ Daniel 小我小，你小我
两岁，
你小我两岁，
4岁。
I'm sorry， 我不会 math， 小我两岁。然后，对，然后这次回来加拿大，就是也就有跟 Daniel catch up， 我们前几天还去爬山 就是 very fun。我们爬了蛮久的，然后也聊了蛮多，然后就刚好聊到，对，可以请 Daniel 来直接把他那一天跟我讲的一些有趣的故事跟 adventure 直接录成 podcast。 约会这本来就是一件很不容易的事情，那尤其你在不了解对方个性跟喜好的情况下，你可能会就是需要去做出一些让对方喜欢的事情，所以呢，
对对对，
才想说这一集呢就来邀请一下这位约会大师，因为在加拿大、因为在加拿大跟台湾都有蛮多约会经验的，所以可以跟大家分享一下所谓成功的约会应该是什么样子，然后有什么诀窍。好，
也有不成功的约会了
就像刚刚讲的，如果比如说约会就是在还没有很了解对方的情况下就是碰面嘛，那你通常认识一个女生你会认识多久才提出就是要不要出来约会或吃个饭喝个咖啡，一个约会的邀约这样？
一般我觉得约会就是跟新的人碰面的话有两种，第一种呢就是你们是朋友的朋友的认识的，所以假如我们会去玩桌游啊，然后这个女生或者是这个男生带一个朋友，然后我觉得他觉得蛮可爱的，我就会就像这种情况下面呢，我就会跟他加个 IG 啊，加个 Line 啊或怎么样，然后就问他你要不要喝，就是来把他约出来 grab a coffee。
等一下，你一加完之后马上问的第一句话就这个
对，我觉得如果是朋友之间的朋友，我就会比较快一点，因为我就一般就如果我们在玩桌游的话，我就会已经跟他先聊大概聊了一下了啦，然后加完以后呢，我就觉得想要弄蛮清楚的，就说我是对你有兴趣，你要不要我们可以吃个晚餐啊或怎么样怎么样的。
哇，你就直那我好奇，所以你在加 IG 或 Line 之前，就是你也会表现就已经是很直接对他有兴趣的样子吗？
对，我觉得我会。
哦，
在加拿大是这样，我觉得。
所以你也不会，所以你也是算是你一见面你就知道你对这女生有没有好感，也不是说那种我们要多聊聊看我才确认我要不要跟你出去约会这样。
是，我觉得见一面就算我们只有花一点点时间聊天，我觉得他如果 如果他表面长得不错的话，我会有一点兴趣。然后呢，如果想要再更了解他，我就会觉得在像吃个晚餐啊，或者是我们去走一走、散步啊，这样就会更认识他，然后才会知道他会不会是一个很好的对象。
哦、所以 OK 我懂了，所以就不管怎么样，如果你稍微有一点兴趣，你就会觉得 OK 那我们就试试看。
是的。
哦、好，那所以你通常会怎么讲，就 你说如果你要你加了他的 IG， 你通常你的第一个讯息会怎么讲？因为通常我觉得很多人都不知道到底你要怎么开始那个对话。
对对对对，我应该就会哦，真的很高兴可以在这个人的家跟你认识，我会跟他说哦，我知道这个蛮好的餐厅，然后我就想说你会不会想要跟我一起出来，我们可以来吃个饭啊，然后更认识对方。
哦、
我就会这样说啦。
OK OK， 那假如说女生在这个时候就是没有很，就是她没有说好，然后她就是觉得不要，那你还会继续想要跟她聊天吗？
就不会
哦，真的哦，就这样没了。
对，我觉得一般女生都蛮那个，他们不是蛮敏锐的，对不对？是我这样用对吗？
嗯、
对他们一般知道，如果一个男生这样子加他们，然后问他们哦要不要来吃个饭啊，他们一般都已经知道那个男生是不是有想要跟他们有什么
兴趣
关系的兴趣之类的。
对 对。
所以呢，如果他们马上拒绝的话，我一般就不会再往下追了，因为我觉得这样会变得太 creepy。
就是会有一点让人家觉得不舒服啦。
对对对，然后我也不想要让我们朋友之间的朋友变得很尴尬之类的。
可是你连朋友就不会想继续当了吗？
我觉得我不会这样子，
就是不要再浪费时间。好，下一位这样。
是的，因为生命太短了，你生命不可以有太多人。
哇，果然是约会大师，时间管理啊，时间管理大师。好，那另外一个问题就是刚刚讲，因为现在大部分人都是用就是比如说软体聊天，那刚刚你讲的一个方式是透过朋友，就是在一个比如说朋友的生日 party 或什么什么认识、
yeah.
那如果万一今天是以交友软体，因为现在 COVID 嘛，其实也很难就是有实体的活动或聚会，那透过交友软体，那要怎么样很有技巧的去跟人家聊天，然后要怎么样约出来见面？
我觉得交友软体就比较简单一点，因为一般在软体上面的人都是他们已经大部分啦都已经准备好要交往、或者是决定要可以跟男生或者女生碰面了、就是比朋友还要再更先进一点。所以呢，我觉得一般只要像，我不知道像台湾是不是好像是用 Tinder， 还有 Bumble， 我听说是用这两个啦。我在台湾的时候是用 Tinder，然后一般我觉得交友软体就比较简单，你一般因为他们也要喜欢你，你们才会 match 嘛。
对对。
所以呢，就是表面上你们两个都喜欢对方，然后之后就是开始聊天。所以聊天的话，就这个就。我觉得把女生问出来比较简单，但是呢、要女生回你就有比较难一点点，因为你需要让这个女生觉得哦，这个人很好笑啊，或者是她有什么样的看法，我很喜欢跟她通话之类的。因为你要想、因为你要想你要 stand out， 就是你想要想独一无二。我不知道是不是这样子用，
就是你要跟人家与众不同。
对，就是这样子。
那这个技巧在于什么？要怎么样让自己跟其他人与众不同？
这个技巧就有点难，因为不同的女生喜欢不同的东西，所以我觉得最好的就是你就是要开放一点，然后当自己用自己的 humor，
用自己的幽默，
对自己的幽默去那个跟这个女生来聊天，然后她喜欢的话就。他就会回你嘛，那不喜欢的话，那你就不用再 try 了，不然你会造成人家的
困扰。
困扰 ，yes。
哦、oh, ，OK， 所以重点是在于你就是做自己， 反正有那么多个对象，反正有很多机会嘛，因为反正你每天你都可以去滑不同的人，所以做自己，然后就是反正喜欢你就喜欢，不喜欢的就 OK 拜拜，反正还有很多其他的人。
对
那你通常会聊多久你才会提要出来见面？
如果是在软体上面碰面的话，我一般想要赶快的把这个女生带出来，所以我觉得一天到三天，我就会把他们问出来，有可能也不会到三天，我觉得一天到两天是最好的啦。因为你要想就是你只是其中一个男生，所以如果呢你是男生的话，然后你在软体上面你有十个对象，这个女生一定有一百个对象因为女生一般都是比较会拿到比较多那个 matches 的。
对，
这是我的我朋友跟我说的经验啦。
啊，
所以你想要赶快把这个女生要出来，就是把她带出来，
约出来，
对，约出来。如果不赶快的话，其他男生会动得比你快，然后你就损失了。
而且提早约出来也不会浪费时间啊，万一其实聊那么久，可是本人见到就就
对，真的
有吗？你有碰过很多这样子的，就是你怎么本人差这么多？
我觉得长相目前我还没有碰到就是差太多的，但是就是有一些碰到，然后你就会发现你们两个在面对面的时候聊天，你们没有这么的配对方，因为我觉得简讯呢，你可以有时候可以看一下，你可以想一下再回。这样就跟面对面就有点不一样。
对，
因为面对面就要靠一下你的 wits，
靠你的机智的反应。
是
哦，所以你们连比如说你也不会说我们来打电话，我们来视讯，就是直接约出来这样。
对我不会打电话视讯。
哦，
有可能女生我知道有一些女生朋友他们会想要先打电话视讯，因为他们是因为安全的关系啦。
对啊、
就是怕什么怪怪的叔叔或什么东西的。
对没错。所以你这样约对方也是很直接了当吗？就直接说我想要约你出去这样。
对啊，我觉得女生约出来就是你大概就说你喜欢什么样的食物啊，因为女生都很爱吃嘛。
没错，
就说你很喜欢你喜欢什么样的食物啊，如果喜欢这个我就会建议一个餐厅，我就说你会不会想要这个时间跟我来到这个餐厅，我们可以一起试试看这边。然后就从那边开始
啊。所以其实人家说那个真的是如果有抓住对方的胃，可以真的抓住对方的心。
对，说得好。
那你觉得在用交友软体上面这样比如说约会，你觉得在加拿大跟台湾有差吗？
如果在软体上面的话，
就这边也是，
就是
加拿大这边大部分也是用 Tinder 吗？还是用其他的？
这边加拿大是有其他的 ，Tinder 也有用，但是呢，我怎么说，在加拿大 Tinder 的话，我们是专门就是大部分用 Tinder 的人都是想要那种一夜的
一夜情
，one night stand， 一夜情，
yeah，
对，大部分 Tinder 是来用一夜情，然后。我们如果你想要真正交往，就是找一个对象的话，我们是有其他软体，
像什么在这边？
像 Hinge 是一个很大的。
有，我很多朋友都在用 Hinge。
对 ，Hinge 在这边是很大，但是我听说台湾没有人在用 Hinge，
好像没有听过。
我觉得台湾大部分在用 Tinder 的人，也有一夜情的啦，但是也有就是要找那个。一个对象的，
真的对象。对啊，我其实也蛮多朋友从 Tinder 都找到他们很稳定的对象。其实
是
对哦。 OK， 对，我突然间刚刚想说我要就是好好介绍你一下，就是为什么要跟你聊约会。因为我记得你是不是跟我讲过你到底约会过几个女生啊？你那时候好像跟我讲个很可观的数字，但我有点忘记了。
我们是讲就是真的有变成男女朋友吗？还是
没有？就是约会啦。
哦，约会哦，有很多个，因为
数不清吗？
也不是数不清啦，但是我觉得20到30个吧，就是不同的女生出去过。
而且你说这是一年吗？你是一年之内约会了20到30个女生吗？
对，我觉得一年大概是这个数字。
哦，一年大概是这个数字。
对，
那
我大概如果我要选约会的，因为我现在才23岁，我好像是20岁到23岁，在这个range 里面的时候才开始真正的有去约会。
约会
大概就是一年20到30个不同的对象。
哇，然后成功的几率多大？就是你后来真的有修成正果了？
成功的几率大概蛮低的，就是有一些你真的遇到，不然就是你不喜欢，不然就是对方不喜欢你，所以就是约会真的是很困难的一个东西，找到一个对象是很困难。大概一年二十个、三十个，应该只会有大概2-3个你真的会有什么感情吧，就是对他有好意。
好感，好感，
好感 ，yes， yeah。
哇 ，OK， 二三十个里面只有2-3个，那就是10%的机会。OK， 其实 not bad， 就是代表说，其实如果你只要你愿意，就是多去认识人，其实你还是有机会。所以
是的，
所以其实因为我有些朋友他们就会觉得，懒啊，不想啊，然后可是又一直抱怨自己找不到对象。其实还是要多，就是比如说，尤其。如果你觉得时间紧迫，还是可以多去认识人，还是可以提高几率啊。
就像玩乐透嘛，就是一定要也要 try 啊。
等一下，玩乐透这个比喻不太好。
你可以失败一百次，但是只需要那一次就可以了。
就只要需要那中那一次，对。
对对对。
享福一辈子。好，
对对对，
那下一题就是想要问说，那你在。就是加拿大跟台湾跟女生，你觉得约会上面有什么差别吗？
我觉得约会上最大的差别，我觉得这是我个人自己的想法啦。因为在加拿大我有开车，然后就是空间比较大，所以我觉得给我那种让我可以感觉像男人的那种感觉比较大一点，因为我可以开车去接他，我可以说我们去。我7:30可以来接你，我就觉得你去开车去接一个女生，我觉得蛮浪漫的。
对，
所以就给我更多自信。
对，
但是呢，在台湾交往，因为我在那边没有开车嘛，所以我就必须跟他们在捷运站碰面。我7:00在松山火车站跟你碰面或什么东西？
几号出口？
对，几号出口？哦，东门、西门。对啊，我就
的确好像突然间那个叫什么，那个气场有点弱掉这样。
是是是，我记得我第一次在台湾跟一个女生碰面的时候，其实那时候我对台湾也不太熟悉，所以我在东门、西门什么门乱七八糟都好像跑了很久，然后也找不到那个女的，真的就差一点回家了。
哇，
因为花了30分钟，然后也人太多人了，根本就找不到。
对，
但是 yeah，
哦哇，所以你觉得 OK？ 除了就是开车跟这边地比较大的差别，还有什么差别？
还有一个差别，我觉得台湾是一个蛮好的约会的一个台湾不要说台湾啦，我觉得是台北，说台北比较好，是一个蛮好的约会，就是一个有一个很好的约会 environment。
怎么说？
因为像在加拿大，你大概带一个女生出去就是吃个饭啊，就这样子。因为加拿大就吃个饭，你又不可能去爬山。所以
为什么不可能去爬山？
因为你才刚跟这个人碰面啊，你要去爬山，你要开个2个小时到山坡那边去。
OK， 太尴尬了，对对。
人家会觉得你要是把他带过去，把他做的怎么样，然后埋在树里面。
Oh my gosh，Yeah，actually，Yeah， 我懂，我懂。
Yeah。所以我觉得在台北约会就比较方便，就是我们可以去吃个饭啊，然后可以去卡拉 OK 啊，或是玩什么东西啊，可以去 mall 去 shopping 啊之类的。
等一下，这边也可以卡拉 OK， 也可以 mall， 也可以 shopping 啊。
这边东西很贵，
什么？所
以呢，你去约会的时候呢，你在这边如果你要带女生约会，你要准备要付很多钱。 所以最好还是呢，就是喝杯咖啡啊，吃个饭，然后就回家了。如果喜欢的话，你再说；不喜欢，赶快带回家。
等一下，那你既然刚刚讲到很贵，你是因为在这边都是还是一样男生付钱吗？就是有差别吗？
有，我觉得在这边，每个男生不一样。我知道我有很多男生朋友，他们会，他们不太喜欢付钱，所以他们不喜欢的话。如果不喜欢这个女生呢、啊，他们就会哦，我们分担好了，你付你的，我付我的，然后就走了。对，但是一般是我的话，如果我问这个女生，就是哦，你要不要出来吃个饭？就算我不喜欢，我一定会先付。
哦，
因为我自己觉得这个就是哦，谢谢你跟我出来，虽然我们不配，但是没关系。
哇 ，gentleman，
对啊，因为你不知道，有可能这个女的会变成你的朋友，然后她会介绍她的朋友给你啊。
哦，原来是这样，要给自己留后路。
对，这个是一个 investment。
哦，这是一个投资，
okay?
投资。
是的，是的。
对，是让自己的名声不要，就是让自己名声好，留下好的印象，这样。
嗯，因为这个世界非常的小，有可能下个礼拜你会跟她的朋友在，网络上碰面，然后呢，他们就会开始讨论你啊。
哦，哎，这个，哎，这个不错哦。所以其实这件事情很重要，就是你不管怎么样，你再不喜欢那个人，你还是要很 gentleman， 就是还是不要让自己显得好像很，你知道，就是名声臭掉啊。这件事很重要。
对对对。
那万一女生很坚持她要付呢？就是或至少 split， 你还是一样，就是很就是 no， 我们就是我付。
哦，如果他真的想要跟我拼的话，我一般不会太那个 what refuse，
不会太拒绝，
对，我不会太拒绝啦，我就会让他，我们就会让他那个分担。但是我发现，一般想要跟我分担的女生，就是代表她也没有那么的。
有兴趣、
太有兴趣，对，因为他们不想要就是欠你啊、哦、之类的。
对对对对对。哦，原来 OK。那在台湾也是这样吗？台湾你也是发现也是跟加拿大差不多，女生也都是你付钱，然后女生也不太会拒绝这样。
嗯，我觉得在台湾女生就比较会让男生先付。
嗯，
我是有朋友他们在台湾的交往经验是，他们希望那个男朋友付全部的东西。
哇、wow、
所以这个就我觉得就是我不知道我当然不是每个女生都这样子，但是我听说就是台湾交往就是这样，我觉得这个是跟加拿大比最大的一个差别啦。
那所以在加拿大是怎么样？
加拿大一般你开始如果你们两个都喜欢对方的话，
嗯，
女生大部分都会就是哦你付这个然后轮流付然后我付这个之类的。
哎、欸，好像是我自己的经验是，因为我以前在加拿大就是约会的时候，的确就是可能跟男生的话，就是男生还是会想要多付一点，但是我觉得在这边的女生，加拿大女生就会觉得哦、因为我也就是我们都是平等的嘛，所以我也会想要付出，那虽然我有付，但就是男生还是会想说哦，我可以多付一点，那没有关系，可以让他多付一点，但不会就是说全部都要男生这样。
是是是，
对，我觉得好像是在这边女生的一个尊严。就我也有听说在这边的男生朋友跟我讲说，如果他们出去约会，然后当然啦就是礼貌上都男生付，但如果那个女生完全没有表示一点东西，就是直接就是那种哦你应该付，其实男生说这是个大扣分耶。对，但是在台湾就不一样，在台湾好像男生就是很自动的哦，都我来付，然后你不准付这样子。
对对
对，对，我好像我自己碰到的经验也是这样，所以的确是文化上不太一样，但我就会觉得就是 对啊，我也会觉得就是可能这边女生比较 strong and independent 吧，就会比较独立啊，
就是文化不同啦。
对，文化不一样啦。好，那下一个问题，有没有什么必中的约会技巧？就是不管什么样个性的女生都抵挡不了。哎呦，
哎呦，这个呢，好像是不太会发生的。
什么意思？什么意思？
因为每个女生都有喜欢不一样的，除非你是真的像明星一样帅，你又长得高，身体又壮，又开一个非常好的车，那这样子就够了，几乎每个女生
对我就不行，没有啦。
哇
因为你知道吗，就是我在想说你讲完这一题回答完之后就可以直接试试看会不会在我身上有用，但先不要给你压力好吗，你先回答你的。
一般在我觉得在那个软体上面碰面的人都是会先看到表面上嘛，
一定啊，
所以我觉得表面还是很重要，然后如果你又可以给对方看到哦你有一个 financial independence，
就是你经济是可以很独立的，
你经济可以啊，人长得也不错啊，然后又有好工作，我觉得这个就是最好的一个 pick up line in a way。
什么意思？
就是这个是唯一的技巧。
所以你会直接就跟那个女生讲说我经济独立这样？
没有啊，就是你可以在你的照片上面你可以秀给他们看你的经济有多独立。
像怎么样秀？
像假如你有一台好车啊，你就会在你的车上拍啊，或者是
但是不行我看到这我就会觉得这男生有一点爱慕虚荣。
对啊，但是呢你又不是在，你又没有在软体上面。
好，但 OK 好继续，就这是我自己的，就是如果 OK， 我觉得我很尊重，就是那种比如说自己经济其实非常独立，就是其实赚还不错的钱，但他是比较低调的，这反而会更吸引我，还是是因为我个性的关系，搞不好是我个性的关系啦。
但是因为在软体上面，你都是要你，如果你是男生的话，你在跟其他男生竞争，所以呢，你就是要想办法把自己放在上面是最好的自己。就你不需要很炫耀，但是就是那些小小的东西让人家觉得哦这个人还不错，他可以对我好，他有那个能力可以对我好。对，
所以就是放一些比如说车子，好，除了车子那还有什么其他可以展现自己的方式？
就是你喜欢出去吃饭啊，喜欢吃就是好餐厅啊之类的，
高级的之类的。
对，然后穿衣服你也是穿的 style 也是好看啊。
哦，
就是不要你的全部的 profile 全部都是你穿两件衣服而已。
真假的啦？
对啊，网络上online dating 就是这个样子。
好，那如果我们不讲 online dating， 如果是 in person， 就是你到时候真的跟这女生约出来，有没有什么技巧？
我觉得就是要对女生要有耐心，然后要善良，然后不是只对这个女生善良，就是如果你们去吃饭啊，你也要对那个服务生善良啊，对你的司机善良，怎么样，就是对他们都好一点。
就是 everything is a test， 就是你所做的每一件事情都是一个考验这样。
对对对对，像帮女生开门啊，这些小东西女生都会注意到。
其实会、
啊、
就连你身上，就如果你连身上如果你有喷古龙水或你有什么味道香味，其实女生都也很敏感。
对对对，或是你有什么，你脸上出去的时候呢，看一下脸上有没有什么杂毛啊。
杂毛这个也太夸张了吧，这个真的是哇。好啦，你也
就是要都准备好啦。对啊，然后就是那些小事情，就是不要觉得哦我做这个他应该也不会看到，然后就不做。
哦，
对，就你带女生出去呢、
okay.
就像带妈妈出去一样。
你确定要这样讲吗？
如果你的第一个 date 啦，你又不是要做什么东西。
对，
就是
带妈妈出去不是很随性吗？去买菜啊什么的。
没有啊，我会帮妈妈开门。
哎呦，
帮妈妈拿菜，你们去 shopping 的话就拿衣服啊之类的。
好，你是一个好儿子，很棒很棒。
谢谢谢谢。
好啦，那个现在目前 Daniel 还是单身，所以如果听到的观众有兴趣的话，可以等一下 message 一下，交换一下资讯。是，好，那个其实今天是来帮 Daniel 征友的。
哦，原来是这样子。
没有啦，开玩笑的。好，那 如果你这样约会的过程当中，你自己是觉得感觉很不错，但是你后来发现对方就是没有特别的热络，就算你很喜欢那个女生，你还会继续吗？还是你就想说跟刚刚一样算了？
我就会算了，因为呢，我以前也是，就是如果一个女生没有太多兴趣的话，虽然我很喜欢她，我以前会一直追，一直追，
嗯，
但是我发现这就是人的个性嘛，就是你会想要你没办法拥有的，
嗯，
而且如果一个，然后呢，如果一个人太 desperate 的话，
嗯，就是太想要，太饥渴的话，是，
对，如果我太想要一个女生的话，她就会越来越觉得你很烦啊之类的，
嗯，
所以呢，最好呢还是就是，如果她对你没有兴趣，你就说哦好，没关系，那就 good luck， 谢谢你，就是至少有跟我吃个饭之类的，
嗯，
然后就这样子就结束了，
哇哦。那
因为你不知道，有可能五年以后你又碰到他，嗯，然后他就觉得哦，这个男生其实还长得不错，人还蛮不错的，给你第二个机会。
嗯，哦，OK， 所以就是潇洒爽快一点啦，不要死缠烂打。
对，
所以你现在就也没有所谓要追女生这种事情咯？
没有，我觉得追女生是对方也是要有一点点的那个 interest， 你才能追得成。
嗯，
不然
也有兴趣啊。
对啊，不然我觉得就是在我的生命里面和在我朋友周围的生命里面，
嗯，
你一般越追越久的话，对方是不会更喜欢你的。
OK， 我觉得这就是加拿大跟台湾还有一个很大的差别，就是在加拿大真的好像男生不会去追女生，就是通常都是所谓的 dating，嗯，就是哦，就是大家就是吃饭，然后如果有兴趣再慢慢，就是男生不会主动一直去追女生，就是你不会看到像那种韩剧那种男生就是每天在那边送花有的没。但是在台湾呢，女生好像潜在的就会期待男生有某种追求的方式，就是好像就是一个文化，就是男生就必须要献殷勤啊，然后要很就是浪漫啊什么之类的，好像是这样。欸，
但是在台湾女生也是要，嗯，至少也要就是给他一点兴趣嘛，不可能对他冷漠然后又想要这个男生追吧。
可是有一些女生我不知道，欸，我也有看过女生就是她其实是对他没有兴趣，但她很享受那个被追的过程，所以可能就会也不是说 lead him on， 但就男生就还是会觉得哦，我还是有希望，那我就是继续追这样，
然后之后那个男生就会被伤到，他就会很痛苦。
对啊，好像是这样。
对啊，
我有看过蛮多这样的案例的。
对，因为这个发生太多次在我的生命当中，所以呢，我现在呢都不会追太久。
最久是多少？你会给他多久时间？
我会看情况，大部分一般都是几个礼拜吧。如果我们在聊天啊什么之类，我觉得他变成有点冷淡，然后呢，
嗯，
就是也没有什么太多兴趣，我就会自己开始。也不会跟他太有那个conversation，
嗯，
我就会慢慢的离开他的生命中。
哇，
就
哇，这真的是这个是约会大师的经验啊。
对，经验。
对，真的是日积月累的经验啊。
对啊，因为你真的你追太久，你男生很喜欢给自己希望，男生们，
嗯，
我发现，
嗯，
然后你就给自己希望，然后之后就会被伤到，然后，
唉 ，OK， 这个刚好这一件事，男生喜欢给自己希望这件事情，昨天我也在跟一群男生朋友聊，然后我就因为我们有女生跟男生，然后我们女生就要讲到说，
嗯，
哇，万一就是比如说你约会出去，然后女生就是没有兴趣，所以就不太去回那个男生。但是男生还是会一直就是想要来约，想要来问，然后我们就觉得啊，你看不懂吗？就是已经拒绝你了，你还看不懂，就不回你就是拒绝你啊。然后就那些男生就摇头就说没有啊，就是男生会觉得哦，你是故意在就是 让我们就是有一点就是叫 play hard to get， 故意欲擒故纵。
对对对，
然后我们女生就完全无法理解，就是没有啊，不想跟你讲，就是不想讲话，你为什么会一直认为就是我要跟你玩这样子。所以男生真的会这样觉得吗？
真的，这个其实常常发生，因为很多男生呢心痛的时候呢，他们会觉得哦，这个女生是不是对我其实没有那么多兴趣，然后他们难过就会跟他们的朋友讲，然后他们的朋友呢就会很支持，就说哦，没有啦，他只是在跟你teasing 而已，他其实还是喜欢你，然后就会给你那种假的希望。然后男生就会喜欢相信对他们有利的，是这样说吗？对，然后就会，
所以身为好朋友还是要直话直说。
是的是的是的，
不要乱给希望。
对，因为男生，我觉得男生我们本来就是那种我们虽然知道有可能这个不会发生，但是我们还是会想要去试试看。
嗯，
然后对，然后女生也一般不会说 no， 就是不会真正的给他拒绝嘛。女生一般都是冷漠冷漠冷淡，然后之后慢慢的离开他的生命。
对啊，
然后对吧，但是男生如果你不跟一个男生说我不喜欢你，他们会一直追下去的。
真假的？
对，
可是你刚刚 OK， 除非是像你这种境界已经伤过很多次，所以你自己就觉得算了，我不要浪费时间，是吗？
是的，因为我已经学过了，已经这一种 lesson 我已经学太多次了，所以现在已经
死心了这样子。
对，我现在已经对自己很了解，我需要做什么。
好好笑哦。不是，因为我之前也有碰过，就是好了，不讲是谁，但是就是真的就是很一直在，就也不是说死缠烂打，就是我真的都不回，然后就是会一直很，他很 gentleman， 就是会一直就是想要约，一直约，一直约。然后我想说，我东西没有回你嘞，你哪来这个自信？然后后来我就很委婉的跟他讲说，哦，就是我觉得我现在就是没有兴趣这样。然后他还是很有自信，觉得说那没关系，等到你觉得
等一下
OK 的时候。
你是说我没有兴趣交往，还是我对你没有兴趣？
我说我没有兴趣交往。然后我也觉得我现在什么意思？
这个就不一样了，因为你说我没有兴趣交往，所以他只是觉得哦，你还没准备好，所以他的时间还是可以来到。
哦，
所以他才一直有自信，觉得哦，你还会在，你有可能你准备好要交往的时候呢，他还是一个好对象，他就会这样觉得。
可是他也从来没有告白啊，所以我也才觉得哦，如果我直接就跟他讲说我对你没兴趣，这样好像也很怪，因为他也没有讲过说哦，就是我喜欢你怎么样子。
对，但这个就是难的部分，你知道吗？因为男生和女生都知道对方在想什么，但是你们就是不敢讲。因为男生他们也是不敢讲，然后呢他们就在等这个女生跟他们出来，然后女生没有兴趣也是不知道该
怎
么说。怎
么拒绝？对
啊， 对
啊，
所以
就放着啊，然后哎 ，OK， 我懂。所以其实如果拒绝，不对啊，因为我刚刚在想说，那这样是不是讲说，如果放着，然后不拒绝，然后那个男生就懂了，就代表说，其实这个男生也经历过蛮多的，就是他应该是蛮有经验的，他才会就像你一样啊，就知道说 ，OK， 我懂，我要就是退这样子。不过，好啦，这个也没什么特别啊，就算知道也没怎么样。好，那回到刚刚那个约会好了。那比如说你们要出来约会，好，行程都是男生，通常都是你男生安排吗？对，这个东西的确就是，到底比如说身为女生，有时候我就会想说，对，到底第一次约会是要让男生安排吗？还是说，对啊，应该是怎么样？
在我的经验，至少在加拿大，我发现女生都比较喜欢男生安排，因为就，而且我觉得男生也喜欢安排了，就是有那种
照顾女生、
照顾女生那种感觉，对。然后就是女生也喜欢那种感觉，所以我觉得行程都是男生会安排的。
可是不是通常都一样吗？就吃个饭而已，有什么还要安排？这就选餐厅啊。
对啊，选餐厅是一个很困难的东西，蔡佩萱小姐，尤其对女生来说，选餐厅，你知道男生有时候要花很多时间在那个 Google Map 上面找哪一些是好餐厅。 找完了之后呢，还要经过女生的同意。
我觉得超好笑，前几天我们去爬山的时候，然后爬完山要选要吃什么东西的时候，然后我记得你好像就问我吧，你就说我要吃什么，我说哦都可以，就是你来决定。然后 Daniel 就开始列一个选，他就开始说那这个，我就说不要，然后那个不要，那个不要，然后就说你不是说让我决定吗，为什么你什么都不要。我就说你不能就给我多一点选项吗？
女生的都可以，都是都不可以的。
超好笑，超好笑。所以男生其实在安排行程这件事情其实是享受的哦，其实是觉得 OK 这样是一个尊重是吗？
对，我觉得啦。
那如果女生就是一直都是女生安排行程，反而男生会觉得，我不知道啊，你有碰过这样的情况吗？就是
其实我没有碰过这个情况，一般因为一般都是男生约女生出来嘛，所以女生也不会太去安排什么东西，他们一般都是让男生带的，至少第一次碰面都是让男生带。
OK， 好，那我还有另外一个问题，就是如果你在约会的时候，你通常是你会碰到你 OK， 这是以女生的角度啦，因为我们女生我们很难去知道说当在约会跟一个男生约会的时候，通常你碰到什么样子的女生你会觉得是最自在而且最吸引你的。
你说我个人吗？
对，你个人或者是你的 I don't know 男性同胞们通常跟你分享的。
哇，这个很难说耶，每个人都很不一样，但是一般我觉得男生都会 OK， 好，我讲 generally 啦，大概的男生都喜欢比较有自信的女生，然后呢
但又不能太自大，
对，这就是在加拿大和台湾很大的差别，因为加拿大的男生呢他们不太喜欢那种很撒娇啊，或者是很 clingy， 中文是什么？
就是很黏，
很黏。对对，
很
加拿大的男生对不太喜欢那种哦，每天都要打电话啊，什么什么什么的。就这边的男生比较喜欢独立一点的女生、就
是对，完全可以理解。
对，对，独立有自信，然后有一个生命的目标。我觉得这都是男生很喜欢的。
哦，泼辣可以吗？
什么是泼辣
？Sassy，
Sassy 我喜欢但是可以啦。有一些男生不太喜欢这种 Sassy 泼辣。
OK， 我觉得在台湾男生能够接受就是比较泼辣、有个性，就是有个性女生比较难。可是，在加拿大反而这边女生我觉得都很有个性哎，而且都通常我觉得比较泼辣，反而就男生会觉得你很幽默，你就是很有想法，是这是一个很有自信的表现。
是是是，
对，所以我觉得这差蛮多的，而且我可以明显就是也发觉在台湾可能男生会通常会比较大男人吧，所以他就会期待女生是比较温柔，他们好像大家比较喜欢温柔、比较乖，然后很体贴，很有气质。
对，
好像对气质这件事情好像在这边反而气质会觉得你就是太可能太害羞会吗？
对，有一点
可能大部分男生会比较喜欢就是讲话就是比较温柔，可能稍微嗲一点。
你突然听起来好可爱哦。
Oh my gosh， 然后在这边就是 sup man， what's up dude。
好，没有这么的 bro right。
好了，开玩笑的，我也是可以很多很多面向的。
哇，你看好厉害。
可能我第一次约会就是这样，就是讲话都很温柔，然后可能过一阵子就哎
太大的转变了吧。
哎，去洗碗。
哇，
没有啦，那是我对我弟讲话，没有啦。开玩笑开玩笑。好那再另外一个问题，如果第一次约会你会约女生去看电影吗？
第一次我会，但是呢我会先吃个饭，然后我看电影呢我都会先跟他们讲好，我们先吃个饭啊，然后如果你喜欢这个电影我们可以一起看之类的，就是我会跟他们先说好。 然后其实很少啦，有做过，但是我一般是不会第一次去看电影。
为什么？尴尬吗？
不是，就看电影就是你没办法更了解对方。
哦，我懂我懂我懂。可是看电影，看电影可以制造一点点浪漫感耶。
可以啊，所以呢看电影的时候，就是如果我觉得我要带个女生去看电影，我那时候就已经准备要把我的手放在她的肩膀这样子绕过去了。所以一般会等久一点。
哦、我以为你会直接牵人家的手，没有，你是把手放在肩膀。
哦，对。一般是先放肩膀，我才会牵手，因为我觉得牵手是交往以后我才会比较胆子比较大一点。
哦，哎，所以那 OK， 那我问你，所以所谓你交往是指说已经变男女朋友吗？还是只是 dating 约会这样？
我觉得交往只是 dating 啦，就是约会。
哦，所以那什么时候可以牵手？
什么时候可以牵手哦？
对啊，
嗯。我觉得牵手对我来说是我已经跟这个人说好我们是什么样的关系了。
啊，那不就
是
什么意思？
那时候就是哦，如果我们已经变男女朋友啊之类的
才牵手吗？
我才会牵手。对，我是这样了。
哦，
我知道我的朋友全部都是不一样的。
对啊，
但是我这么晚牵手的原因是因为对我来说，因为牵手你是在public 牵手嘛，
对，
边牵手边走路，公众
场
所，
对，
呀呀呀。然后那时候我就觉得，这个就好像是公布给大家说， 哦，这个是我的女人，
哦，
我才会跟她牵手。嗯，
哦，有趣，哎，的确，的确，你这样讲，我好像能够理解。
对，我的看法是这样，
因为我原本以前也是会这样认为，就觉得说，哦，除非我们关系是已经男女朋友才会。牵手，因为不然你看你如果比如说你在逛街然后你碰到突然碰到一个熟人，
这个有发生过，所以
什么是发生什么事情，
就是在我在跟一个女生，我没有跟这个女生交往，那时候我还没有讲好，
对，
然后呢就牵手，然后在mall 里面走一走啊，然后呢碰到朋友，然后呢就很难介绍你知道吗？
对啊，你怎么介绍？
对啊，他就说哦这个是你女朋友吗？我就说哦不是，是朋友，他就很奇怪，你知道吗？
会牵手的朋友，
对，所以之后我就没有再这样子了。
欸，我突然间觉得我可以做一首歌，牵手的朋友，
牵手的朋友，
好好笑哦。欸，对啊，我就觉得就是这一点很尴尬。可是，比如说，我也有见过那种，就是我知道这个朋友，他本来就是，比如说他。真的没有想要进入一个就是 serious 的关系，所以呢他就是常常会 date 不同人，可他 date 不同人的时候他们都会比如说有很亲密的接触，所以每一次我们就是大家聚会的时候他都会就是会带他当时在 date 的人，然后每一次都是很亲密，然后所以我后来也就是开始习惯才觉得说哦，好像牵手这件事情对于很多人来讲并不是说我一定要跟你当男女朋友才是。
嗯，
对啊，所以可能每个人都不太一样吧。
对，每个人都不太一样啦，就是看你的自己的 boundary， 你觉得是在哪里。
嗯，那所以通常你大概会约会几次你才会开始勾肩搭背，或者是开始会觉得说哦我可以跟你有比较肢体上的接触，比如说你会拥抱吗？好，千万不要错过下一集更精彩的，我觉得是蛮劲爆的一些话题。好啦，那希望你们喜欢今天我跟 Daniel 的有趣比较轻松的 dating Q&A， 那么我们就下次见咯。如果喜欢记得要订阅 subscribe 我的 podcast， 然后如果有任何想要跟我们分享留言问问题你都可以欢迎留言跟我说。 We'll see you next time. Bye.
星期每个周末，不论我在睡觉洗澡或在工作，忍不住 Can't get you off my mind It happens every time 没有你我就很难过你让我分心我被你吸引你的一切永远留在我的心里一想到你我就不停地想这种感觉无法控制那怎么办你就是世界上的最美有你在我身边我不会累
从来没有认识过 Somebody like you 人一直那么完美
应该怎么表达我的心意Perfect girl, I need you in my life 你并不会像一般的女孩只是要我去送她很贵的名牌从第一次碰面我不会忘记那一天我耍酷戴着墨镜感觉到爱有某一种魔力还没开口已经非常有默契你就是世界上的最美有你在我身边我不会累怎么表达我的心意为什么我这样子说这种事情我没办法一直拖现在要让全世界知道我们的关系开始广播一辈子追你一辈子觉得你可爱一辈子陪你一辈子给你我的爱我的宝贝别再等待我的一切我的未来
不知道应该
怎么
好奇你说爱你等眼睛睁开 It's you, you
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my podcast, Ariel's Whisper. Today, we have a very special guest joining us. He is the one and only Daniel Liu. He is one of my closest friends here in Canada. We've known each other since when I was in high school. And recently, we were just catching up. And like the stories that he told me regarding dating were actually pretty interesting. So I just thought, hey, maybe I should have just recorded this into a podcast. So here we are. Let's welcome Daniel Liu.
Yay. Hi, Yay. Guys. Hi. My name is Daniel.
Yeah.
That's it. And I'm 23 and I am in Richmond, BC.
Okay, too much information. We don't need to know. Just kidding. Wait, why do you have to emphasize the fact that you're 23?
I don't know.
Do you feel proud that you're 23? Do you feel you're old or do you feel you're young?
No, I don't. I feel like I'm young.
Oh. So
23 is a young age, but I feel old.
How come?
Maybe because...
Of all the dating experience that makes your heart jaded and like
yes,
you feel broken、
right.
and like you just、yeah. want to find someone to settle down. Wait, are you at the age where you're like, I want to find someone to settle down already?
I think, right, I'm at the stage, yes. But I think at this age, most of the people at my age, they don't want to settle down yet. But personally,、mm-hmm. I feel like I am ready to settle down.
So you're going to probably look for someone...older
than me
I mean like because you're just saying like people around your age don't want to settle down right
yeah I could that、mm. I'm not too picky I mean when it comes to age I think age is okay as long as I think the most important thing is life stage
Mentality, I think.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
Right. So the reason why I invited Daniel was like the other day we went hiking and he was like, oh, I think I dated like 20 to 30 girls in a year. And I was like, say what? That's a lot.
Yeah, maybe not dated. Like I've been on dates with that many. But like, yeah.
And he was like, per year. And I was like, wow, so you do this every year. My goodness. Like, so you must have had so much experience, just I guess regarding dating and like getting to talk to girls and know girls. Probably, yeah, a lot of stories that you can share with us. So that's why today I just want to talk about dating, because I think it's a topic that like everybody likes to talk about or listen to. I don't know. Yeah. It's just something quite interesting, right? Because we all go through it and it's very hard. I think that's why, like, it's very hard to really find find success in dating. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What would you say your success rate is? Let's say, because you like date like 20 to 30 people in a year. Like how is it usually, I don't know, like regarding results?
Success rate, probably like, you know, 10%, maybe like 20. It's mm-hmm. yeah, it's I think dating is a big numbers game. Mm. You just got to go on dates and see what you like, what you don't like. And even if you like someone, they might not feel the same way back. Mm. So it's a lot of just testing and finding out who you are and what you're into. Mm. So yeah, there's a lot of that.
Mm. So it's kind of like just go out there and explore and like, I guess don't think too much, right? I mean, like,
yeah.
But that's the thing, because like you are pretty extroverted, and usually, like, for introverts like me, I hate dating. Like, I don't go on dates. I don't know. I just find that it's like such a waste of time and energy and money if I'm not interested in a guy, then I just like, I don't know. I
waste
won't even
of money if you're doing it right. The guy should be paying for everything.
Well, time is money, Daniel.
Okay, fine.
Wait, so are you the kind of person where, like, when you ask a girl to come on a date, it doesn't have to be like, oh, you really like her. It's more like, oh, I don't know, you see a potential? Like, how does it work usually for you?
Yeah, when I meet them, I generally know if this is someone that I'm attracted to, like physically or just the overall vibes that I'm getting. And if I am interested, then I will ask them to hang out, get to know them more. And that's why I will determine if I can really date this, like be in a relationship with this person.
Oh.
Yeah.
How long does it usually take for you to figure out if this person is dateable?
I think after the first date, people... Yeah, it depends on what you guys talk about. But generally, my first dates, I have pretty deep conversations. And usually, the first dates are the longest. Mm. I think all of my first dates usually last quite long, like 8 to 10 hours.
10 hours?
Yeah. And okay, that's a reoccurring... I know, that's a reoccurring theme for my first dates.
Wait, what do you even do for 8 to 10 hours?
So, like, you go for dinner, and then you just talk, and you talk, and... There's a lot to talk about. And if you're both interested, the conversations, they go on for a very long time.
Where do you carry these conversations after a dinner? Like, where do you go?
Oh, I take them to a cake shop or a dessert place, a nice cafe. Mm-hmm. We could go for a walk in the cafe. Mm-hmm. And then afterwards, after we eat desserts, sometimes I like to drive around, go to some nice scenic night views, sit there and talk even more.
Wait, what's one nice scenic night view here in Vancouver?
Okay, a really good one that I enjoy is there's this highway from Richmond crossing into Vancouver, the half globe highway. There's like a globe in the middle.
Oh, I love that. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
And then you can just watch airplanes fly over and you can just talk. Or at the end of River Road, you can watch the waters. Sometimes there are stars. Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm just asking this for my own. just curious because you know, I have 2 weeks left here, right? And I want to like make the most out of it. I'm just thinking of like places I can still explore. So,
oh, I see.
Anyway, sorry, back to you're saying usually your dates are 8 to 10 hours. That is a very long time.
Yeah, I know it seems really crazy, but when I actually hang out with people and when I get home and I see the time, I'm like, damn, this was a really long date.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that means you usually ask them out for dinner or lunch?
I usually do dinner. I like doing dinner just because set the mood, you know, a little bit more romantic.
Okay.
And because you can do more romantic activities after dinner as well.
So if it's like 8 to 10 hours, what are the usual questions that you ask? Because you said usually it's like deep conversations, right? Are there like standard questions you would ask on a first date to get to know the
person? Just standard, like, oh, what do you do for your hobbies? What do you do for work? That kind of stuff. You know, were you born in Canada? You know, what's your history? Like as in your living situation,
your
that kind
history?
Of stuff. No, like as sorry, not history, but you know, like were you in Taiwan for a bit? Were you in China? Or when did you move to Canada? That kind of history. That's what I mean.
Oh yeah, I always ask people those as well. It's very interesting. It's very interesting.
It branches out into more topics.
Yeah.
And and one thing I like to do is if I feel like the conversations are going well, I want to continue, right? But I want to make sure that they're feeling the same way. So usually I'll be like, oh, so for example, after dinner, I'll ask them, oh, by the way, do you have to go home? Like, are you in a rush to go home? And if you're not, then, you know, there's this dessert place I know that I was wondering if you want to go as well. And then we'll carry on the conversations there. I have had girls where they're not as interested. So they'll take that chance and be like, oh yeah, I gotta go home and do this and do this. So I try to give them like a escape route, like escape, a chance to escape if they are not interested.
Okay.
But generally
That's pretty gentleman of you. That's actually pretty considerate. Cause like, I know like what, for example, especially if you're the one paying for the dinner, like usually girls feel they're like more obligated to like stay a little bit longer or like not make it seem rude that, you know, they want to like just get out of the dinner. Right. So
yeah, exactly. The last thing I want is a girl to feel uncomfortable and feel like she's pressured to be here. So yeah,
that's very nice of you though. Very nice of you. Wait, so then like, you said that usually you would just like categorize, I mean, not categorize, because like for girls, when we first see a guy, usually in our minds, we would be like categorizing subconsciously, okay? Categorizing them into like either somewhat potential date potential or just like straight up friend.
Yeah, I think guys do that a lot more too.
I think
we do that a lot more than girls.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of my girlfriends tell me they are the type that they could fall in love with a guy.
Okay, like, you know what? Okay, so yesterday I like listened to a podcast and the host was talking about how girls are cerebral, but guys are visual. So like for girls, like we can like develop emotions and feelings for someone when it's like, you know, over time or they did something special. It's like, oh my gosh, like so touching, right? But for guys, it just seems to be like a visual thing. Like it just, I don't know. That's just how you guys are made. Is that true?
Yeah, that's true for most of us. I'm sure there are some special cases where the guy has fallen for the girl over time. But I think most of us, between my friends and I, we all kind of know what we want right when we meet her. So we know if this is someone we are interested in or attracted to.
What if like the girl gets like super hot over time? Like does that make you guys be like, oh, they're like, you know, gradually even if they like, you know, just become super cute or super hot?
No, because we already know what they what they're like from before, so it's no longer the same.
But like even for super hot girls, when they remove their makeup, you know, like you see the real them too. So it's like,
it's not just about how hot a girl is, Ariel.
Okay, I'm not,
we are not that shallow.
I'm trying to think from the guy's perspective because you guys are visual. Okay, I don't know what's going on in your mind.
There's a lot of just general, yeah, like visual as in, you know, just general vibes that we get from a girl that we mm-hmm. know if this is someone we like. I have met girls where I didn't find them like objectively very hot,
mm-hmm.
but there's just something about the overall vibe that they give that that makes me really attracted to them.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh, so I guess the vibe. So like even if later on they like become very attractive, it's still different. Like it's still
yeah, unless they
change.
Become a completely different person.
Mm.
And it's got to be a really long time. Like I need to not see this girl for 10 years and then I meet her and she's like completely changed.
Mm.
And maybe then I'll be like, oh, okay, not bad.
Not bad.
But so far, I have not had that happen yet.
Okay, that kind of makes sense. So I guess like you would be really straight, like straight up, like upfront about it, right? Like, oh, I'm interested in you. Let's like go out. And like once you, I guess, meet the girl.
Yeah.
Okay. And generally they always like kind of say yes or give you a chance.
And this is on dating apps, right?
Like, apps or like if you like DM them.
If I DM like a mutual friend, I would generally try to play a little safer. I would still want to ask them out, but mm-hmm. it wouldn't be too direct because I want to make sure that I'm not creeping her out because we have a mutual friend and everything.
So how would you word it?
Oh, I'll just be like, hey, it was great. Nice meeting you. Would you like to, you know, grab lunch or something and talk more?
Oh.
And I think generally girls should pick it up, be like, oh, this guy's probably interested.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I guess so. And like usually they're pretty responsive then once you say that.
Yeah, unless they don't find you attractive, then they will tell you, oh, sorry, I'm not ready to be in a relationship.
Wait, they actually say that?
A lot of people do, yeah.
They just up say that when you ask them to just have lunch?
Yeah, sometimes.
Dude, that's... Wow.
If they really feel like you're coming on to them, then they'll say that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, so then if it's like on a dating app, you said it would be different for you?
Yeah, I think on a dating app it's much easier because the elephant in the room is that you're both obviously looking for something.
Right. Yeah.
And that's why you're on dating apps, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot more easy going when you're asking a girl out because it's something they're going to expect eventually.
Mm-hmm.
Just depends on when and how soon.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, just gotta hit up the girls in conversation, make sure you're interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And stand up from the rest of the guys with your own sense of humor and hopefully she likes you.
Define interesting. You said you have to be interesting.
Yes. Basically, you don't want to be one out of 200 guys that's like, hi, how was your day?
So how would you start a conversation?
For me, I would probably find something about her profile or mm-hmm. her bio
mm-hmm.
and I'll say something witty about it.
Oh yeah. Do you have an example?
Oh, it's so hard. Let me think.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's say like right now I'm this girl called like let's say Emily, age 26, and on my profile I say like I'm like Aquarius and maybe I like put down my like MBTI. Oh, I'm an INFJ. I like the nature. I'm currently in Vancouver, staying for a while. I'm a pharmacist. And like, oh, I'm down to like meet new friends and meet new people. Okay, that's my bio. How would you hit me up?
I would probably pick that part where you're a pharmacist.
Mm-hmm.
I'll probably come up with the pickup line that relates to it. Like, oh, I'm feeling sick. Can you prescribe? I'm feeling like lovesick after seeing your profile. Can you prescribe me some medicine? Something like that.
Cringe.
I know it's really cheesy, but I think sometimes it works really well because it stands out.
Actually, it does. It does. If it's like, if this girl, well, I imagine on dating apps, like there would be so many guys or so many options out there, right? So
yeah,
actually, you if you do have like a unique pickup line that like is specific to me, like I would appreciate it. I'll be this guy actually like put thought in it, even though it's super cringy.
Exactly. Yeah.
I just had goosebumps. I was like, did you really do that? But okay.
I think just don't be creepy with your pickup lines. And I think it's okay. It's all in good fun.
Yeah, yeah. I'll be like, okay, interesting. This guy is this guy actually does try. So let's give it a try and see what else he has.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. That's pretty good. Okay. And so how long do you usually talk to the girl before asking her out?
Usually I try to get them out as soon as possible because you're competing with so many other guys. Mm-hmm. Like some of my girlfriends' profiles, they have like hundreds of matches within like a day.
Wait, girl space friends.
Yes, girl space friends.
Okay, this was like the term the other day.
My favorite phrase.
Because yeah. Like Daniel has a lot of friends. He's just very sociable and extroverted, and he's a really good friend. So he naturally just knows a lot of people, and he's always like, "Oh, my girl friends," and he has to like leg. So at the end, he's just like, "My girl space friends." I'm like, I love this term. My boy space friend.
Yeah.
This should be like a dictionary term, you know?
Urban dictionary.
Yeah, this should like, you know, be distinguished from like the typical like boyfriend girlfriend. But anyways, sorry, continue to what you're saying.
But yeah, a lot of my girl space friends, they have a lot of matches within a day. Mm. So you're competing with hundreds of other guys. And the more you talk on the apps, the longer you're putting yourself at a disadvantage. Because there's going to be guys that's trying to get her to come out within a day, within 2 days. Mm. So you got to match that. So try and get a conversation going, you know, say something witty and ask her what she likes to eat and just ask her out. I think some people get too nervous and they overthink it. Mm. But you just got to shoot your shot because, you know, yeah, you guys are all in the same game. Dating is a game.
It's a game. Wow. Yeah. So, okay, so let's say you do ask the girl out. Do you usually just like go to a restaurant or like how does it usually work?
Yeah, mostly I would try to take them to a restaurant. I'll ask them, "Hey, what kind of food do you like?" For example, if they like Italian food, I'll take them to a nice Italian food place. I'll suggest it to them. And if they're down, then we will go. Mm. I'll pick them up, take them out, and then we'll have food and talk. That's generally how it goes, yeah.
Okay, so that's the dating scenario that you had here in Canada. What about in like Taiwan? Oh, just to give everybody a little bit of background info. So Daniel was... Wait, were you born in... You were born in Canada, right?
Yes, I was.
But you also had some time, you spent some time in Taiwan.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think I, 5 years old, I was born here, and then I was born in Canada until 5 years old, and I went back to Taiwan. Mm-hmm. I lived until grade 3, and then I came back to Canada, and I've been here ever since. Yeah.
But you still had some dating experience in Taiwan.
Yes, because I do go back to Taiwan every summer for a vacation.
So
you
it's know, like just a few summer months. Summer flings.
Summer flings, that's right.
So like, is it any different in Taiwan in terms of like the dating scenario? Like, let's say, okay, online dating, and then you have to like ask them and meet up, or like, I don't know, just any difference?
Yeah, I think dating in Taiwan was more. It was a lot more difficult for me because number one, I didn't drive. Mm. And number two, I wasn't really familiar with the city. Mm. So a lot of it was just letting the girls take me around instead. So it's definitely
it's like you going on Tinder to find a tour guide.
Yeah, pretty much. But it's definitely like it feels like a gender reversal in a way. Because dating in Canada, it feels like the guys are supposed to handle everything, take the girl out, do all of that. And they're supposed to be like the masculine figure. And girls like to feel that, you know, oh, this guy's reliable, that kind of feeling. Mm. But in Taiwan, I was kind of like, Yeah, the tour guide boy.
The tourist.
Yeah, and I didn't drive either. So I was like, oh, yeah, I'll meet you at this bus stop. You know, and I'll meet you at this MRT station.
Yes, exit number 4.
Yeah, and then we can, you know, take the bus out together to this restaurant. So that's what I was doing in Taiwan.
That's cute, though. That's, well, I guess, like, from my own experience in Taiwan, yeah, like, if you don't have a car, actually, it's very common to not have a car because, like, especially in Taipei, it's like, there's no use, right? If you live in downtown area and, like, you just, like, MRT or bus everywhere, like, driving is, like, so freaking stressful. Like, parking is expensive. Like, parking is hard to find. Yeah, I could just like list a bunch of reasons why I do not have a car in Taipei. But I do agree that like for girls, it does feel a little bit different. Like when a guy actually tries to pick you up, like you feel, I don't know, you automatically do feel that this guy has like more of a sense of like trustworthiness.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just a feeling of security, maybe.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. And like versus just like meeting up, it's kind of like, oh, it's more casual, not casual, but it's more like, you know, in school when you're both like not as financially, I guess, independent and then you like do those things. But again, in Taipei, people usually don't have cars. So I don't know.
It's really cool. It's just interesting to see because in all my girl space friends here, they tell me that not having a car in Canada is actually a big deal breaker.
Oh.
Yeah, because you're just very limited. And because in Canada, everything is kind of wide apart, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You have to travel farther. Transit isn't as convenient as Taiwan.
Yeah, for sure.
So yeah, having a car is like a pretty big deal.
No, that's very true. Like, without a car, you basically cannot do anything.
Yeah, imagine we went hiking and we just took the bus.
Dude.
Oh, man.
Dude, I would, like, unfriend you, but... Yeah, but, I guess, like, having a car does make a difference. But anyway, besides the driving part, are there any differences between dating in Taiwan and Canada?
I think it's also maybe the cultural difference between guys and girls. Like the interactions are different.
Mm.
And I think girls in Taiwan are viewed a certain way and girls in Canada are also viewed a certain way. And it's just as a guy, you have to adapt to the two different cultures.
Mm.
And, you know, you could expect this from I could expect something from a Canadian girl, but it wouldn't be the same if I was out with a Taiwanese girl.
Can you give an example?
Like, for example, maybe girls in Taiwan, they like to be taken care of more when we go out. Like, for example, they want me to buy them like a plushie or something, win them a prize, that kind of stuff.
Wait, what? They ask you to do that?
No, not ask. Maybe they just... It's like, oh, we're at a claw machine and they want to win something and then they think it's really cute. You just have to, I guess, be more of the man in the relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You have to really take care of a girl when you're in Taiwan.
Mm.
You can't be cheap and stuff.
You can't be cheap? What?
Yeah. Gotta flex your money. I'm kidding. Okay, maybe some girls like that. Not you, I know, because you're not a shallow person.
I'm all about the inside, man. I'm just kidding. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, inside of the wallet.
Dude, gotta still take care of me, y'all. Like, okay, please continue.
But maybe in Canada, I think girls sometimes also like to quote unquote wear the pants in the relationship.
Yeah,
they sometimes like to take care of their man, maybe take them out for a day, pay for the movie, pay for the entire day maybe.
Wait, really? I didn't.
Yeah.
What, your friends?
I've had that before.
You've had that? You mean like girls,
like, yeah, girls have, yeah, like, wait, like, oh yeah, today is my treat, that kind of stuff.
Wait, like, were you in a relationship?
We weren't date like in a relationship, but it was just one of the dates. Like, after I date maybe I went out with this girl like twice already.
Yeah.
And she wants to kind of pay me back in return. And that's her way of showing, oh yeah, this is how I want to repay your kindness for all the other dates, that kind of stuff.
That's actually pretty sweet though.
Yeah.
Like I find that, like I was kind of like that in a relationship before, like in Canada. It was more like, that's also my way of showing like affection, right? Like I don't want the guy always to be paying. Like yeah. I feel like we're equal. So like obviously the guy always pays a little bit more, but I would try to like reciprocate that and not just like, I don't know, just have the guy pay for everything. I also feel bad because it's not like, I don't know. I just feel like I should do something as well.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
Yeah. So I guess that also comes to the question of like, do you always pay for your first date or like second date, or do you generally just pay for everything?
The first date, I always pay. Actually, I have a rule for myself that I'll pay for the first date. I'll pay for everything, meaning dinner and desserts and whatever else we end up doing. Second date, I'll also pay for dinner. But for dessert, I kind of like a little bit expecting her to offer and be like, oh yeah, no, let me get it this time. And then third date, you know, I'm hoping that the girl will be like, oh yeah, you know, it's okay, I got dinner this time. So kind of gradually I would prefer the girl to kind of take turns with me, so it's not just a one-sided transaction.
Transaction.
Yeah.
What if the girl offers to pay for the first date? Would you let her?
No, I would not.
What about
generally it's the guy that asks the girl out. And a lot of people in Canada believe that whoever asks who out should be the one paying.
If it's the girl asking the guy out, then she would be the one paying.
Yeah, but I still wouldn't let her.
Right.
That's just my own kind of rule.
What about first dessert? First date dessert?
First date dessert, if she wants to pay, I'll let her pay.
Yeah, because that's usually... Okay, not usually. I've only like...
Whoa, speaking as if you have so much experience, huh?
Okay, I just have to like just say that I don't like going on dates. So like the only dates I've really gone on are like people that I actually like were...
With your boy space friends.
No! Yo, then that wouldn't be called a date, right?
That's, I mean, like, a date can be said in... There are lots of different definitions for date.
Okay, so how do you define a date then?
Well, there are friend dates.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Potential dates.
Really? I don't call friend dates. I just call it a hangout.
Yeah, you could call it that. But then there are people that call it a date. So just don't be too alarmed if somebody is like, oh yeah, it's a date then.
Oh.
Yeah, don't think too much into it.
Really? I always make sure it's not a date. I'll be like, it's not a date.
Yeah, and then they'll be like, oh, well, I didn't mean for it to be like that kind of date. That's just how I say it.
Okay, sure. Cool.
Awkward.
Oh, well. Anyway, back to what were we talking about again? Sorry, we were like completely off like topic.
Who pays for first date?
Right. So in Taiwan, I think also for guys, like they just generally have this like, I guess, concept or tradition of feeling like they should pay for mostly everything as well. And I think girls almost expect that as well from like what I heard from my friends. They're not as like, I think girls in Taiwan or Asia are just not that, I think they're more reliant on the guy usually.
Yeah.
Like, especially financial wise.
Yeah.
Or like even emotional too. They're not as like independent. Well, not independent. I would just say it's just a different, how would you say it? It's just a different cultural thing. I don't know.
Yeah, they're just, I mean, they probably grew up with a certain standard in dating. So it's different. And also it's like very different because us and the more, like when in Canada, the shows we watch and the pop culture that we experience portrays relationship to be a certain way. And I'm sure in Taiwan, there's a way that romance is portrayed
as well.
So maybe that's why. I think a lot of people, they get their dating ideas and advice from dramas or TV shows.
Yeah.
So that's where I learned all my moves. So.
Wow. I mean, actually, when you talk about that, it is very different. You know how, like, for example, in K-dramas, like, you see how the girl is often, like, more suppressed. And they, like, rely on, like, this guy to be the hero to save them from their misery or whatever.
Yeah.
And so they're usually more like the, the more vulnerable one. Definitely the guy is the one who takes more control of the relationship.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Whereas in North America, I feel like girls are more opinionated and they like to take more control. They like to wear the pants in a relationship.
That's right.
Yeah. So I guess for you personally, like, what kind do you prefer?
I think both could work.
Mm-hmm.
But as a Canadian, I do prefer someone that can kind of, like, fight me in a way. Not fight me.
Fight you? Like, oh my god. No, that's
like,
just
someone that has, like, their own mind of, like, their own way of thinking.
Oh, their own
someone
voice.
That can have, like, yeah, their own voice. Someone that can argue with me. Maybe that's not the right choice of words.
Oh, challenge you.
Yes, that's right.
Yes.
Someone that can challenge me, not someone that just submits everything I say.
Wow. Yeah. See, that I think that's really good, because, you know, we have our own voices. Like, we like, especially for example, like me, like, I have a lot of thoughts. I actually think I'm pretty opinionated in certain things. So
yeah,
the more I grow up, the more I realize, oh, like, sometimes I feel a little bit suppressed by, like, the Asian setting, because I feel like people expect a girl to be more, like, submissive and, like, you know, more gentle and, like, better not have too many opinions, don't be too strong-headed. Mm-hmm. But no, I don't think that should be the way. I feel like we should just all be ourselves. Like, if you are generally, like, more submissive and agreeable, then good for you. But if you're generally just, like, more alpha, more strong-headed, then also be you, right? Like, shouldn't change because of, I don't know, what you think you should be like in a relationship. I also think that doesn't last long, because if you're just trying to be someone else.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah, yeah. So I guess, like, sassy girls for you then. Sassy girls.
Sassy, stubborn, but not too stubborn.
Oh my gosh.
Strong-headed.
Oh my goodness. So you're not afraid of fights then?
I don't like fights, but I like, you know,
debates.
A friendly debate.
Debates. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
We can debate as we cuddle each other.
Actually, that is very cute.
I think that's pretty cute. Yeah.
That is actually very cute. So the question is, do you, like, submit at the end to the other person if, like, you know, this debate is going to heat it and it's just not resolved?
It depends on what it is. But mm-hmm. if it's something that's, like, not too life, like, not too game changing,
mm-hmm.
I generally would try to let my significant other win.
Mm.
But if something I'm really passionate about, something I have a really strong opinion about, then if we both cannot budge, then we just we'll just move on, you know, talk about something else.
Oh, so you never really solve it?
Yeah. I mean, I don't think there's ever gonna, I don't think I've ever ran into, like, problems like that.
Okay.
It's more just, like, controversial topics, and we have a different stance on things.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it's not, like, trying to change the other person. It's just, like, you openly discuss about it, get to know each other's views, and, okay, we have different views, but it's okay. We're different individuals. Okay, move on.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
End it with a kiss, so there are no hard feelings.
Oh, I see. Kiss and makeup. Yes. Okay. Anyway, back to dating. So are there any dating tricks that you can share with the audience? Because, you know, you've obviously had so much experience. You probably have, like, a certain, I don't know, skill set or, like, trick or, like, I don't know, just anything that you would usually use, because, you know, okay, this will totally do it.
Okay. Well, there's no one like hard method that will get you the girl 100% of the time.
Mm.
I think it's just important to keep in mind to treat, when you guys go on a date, treat those around you with respect. Mm. Like, for example, the servers or maybe just people you meet on the streets, that kind of stuff. Just be a good person. And I think the girl will notice that. And also try and be more observant in what the girl tells you. For example, if she brings up, oh yeah, I really like this dessert place, maybe you can offer to bring her there after dinner or something. So just pay attention to her, be a gentleman, be nice, be yourself, be thoughtful. Don't think anything is too little to, you know, ignore. Yeah, every little thing counts.
No, every little thing does count. Like they say, the devil is in the details. Like, I think sometimes what touches a girl the most is the fact that like the guy picks up like little details or things that the girl mentions. It's like, oh my gosh, he remembers, and that really makes a guy stand out.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. It's the little thoughts that count. Like sometimes, for me, like one of my love languages is gift giving or like gift receiving. And it's not because I'm materialistic. Like I'm actually not really materialistic. It's the thought. Like I really appreciate the thought behind the gift. And it doesn't even have to be a gift. It can be like a letter or a card or even a message. Like it just makes me feel like, oh, the guy like really is thinking of me constantly and is considerate enough to like show it through, I guess, a gift. So I think that really does like stand out from a guy, for at least for me. So yeah, I think like you said, like even just like how you deal with other people, especially when you're like dating, sometimes you only have like that one chance, like that first date opportunity to observe, like everything is kind of a test.
Pretty much.
It is.
Like you don't want to ruin it by not opening the door for her.
Oh,
you know?
My gosh.
That's something that's such a little thing that you can do well.
Yeah.
And it's so important. But if you don't do it, then it's just a bad impression.
Yeah. That's and do you wait until like the girl, let's say you send her home. Do you wait until she like goes in and then you drive away?
Yeah, I always make sure that happens.
Yeah, for me, I think that's really important because sometimes, like, even as friends, like when I drop off like a friend or someone, like I just make sure they go in before I drive away.
Yeah,
I think that's just like courtesy.
It's just, you know, it's so thoughtful that you're willing to wait until they're safe and then you leave.
Yeah, yeah.
It speaks volumes about what kind of person you are when you do something like that.
Yeah, that is very true.
Like walk on the outside, you know.
Oh, okay, that's a big thing. That is a big thing. Yo, actually, like I always feel like I guess it is quite significant when like a guy's like, oh, just like walk on the inside, and like I'm like, oh, I feel protected. Hey, actually, I think for a girl, like a sense of security is key. So anything that guys do that makes a girl feel more secure, that's like that's like instant like bonus points.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, yeah, like walking on the inside. What else is there? Like, I don't know. Oh, sometimes like when guys have an extra jacket. I think that's also really nice because, like, for girls, we always like underestimate, like, we want to dress nicely, right? And usually, you don't want to like show up with like a puffy jacket or whatever, but it always gets cold. So, especially with your like 8 to 10 hour like day, sometimes I would imagine it would involve a lot of like walking around outside, right? So, there's like an extra jacket, it also makes the girl feel like, oh my gosh, like, you know, I'm being taken care of.
That's right.
Yeah. Good one. Good one. Yeah. Good one. All right. Okay. Next question. So, let's say this date is over and like you totally feel like the connection and chemistry. But you realize afterwards, like, the girl is not as responsive. Do you still pursue or do you still, like, try to ask her out or you just leave it? All right. I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. We will finish the rest of our conversation in the next one. And it's
going to be fun. It's actually going to be quite juicy. We explore a lot of other interesting topics, so make sure you don't miss that one. And remember to subscribe to this channel and to my podcast if you like our podcast, and feel free to leave any comments if you have questions or just anything that you would like to share with me. I'll see you next time then. Bye.
星期每个周末，不论我在睡觉、洗澡或在工作，忍不住 can't get you off my mind. It happens every time. 没有你我就很难过，你让我分心，我被你吸引，你的一切永远留在我的心里。一想到你，我就不停地想，这种感觉无法控制，那怎么办？你就是世界上的最美，有你在我身边，我不会累。怎么表达我的心意？
应该怎么告诉你这个秘密？ I wanna let you know that you're the one for me. 不知道应该如何对你说爱，你等眼睛睁开， It's you, 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 you. 我不想再猜，只想对你依赖，心中无可取代。It's you.
I know what I like, you my perfect girl, I need you in my life. 你并不会像一般的女孩，只是要我去送她很贵的名牌。从第一次碰面，我不会忘记那一天我耍酷戴着墨镜，感觉到爱有某一种魔力，还没开口已经非常有默契。你就是世界上的最美，有你在我身边我不会累。怎么表达我的心意？
应该怎么告诉你这个秘密？ I wanna let you know you're the one for me. 不知道应该如何对你说爱，每当眼睛睁开， It's you, you, you. 现在在只想对你依赖，心中无可取代， It's you, you.
了解为什么我这样子说，这种事情我没办法一直拖，现在要让全世界知道我们的关系，开始广播。一辈子追你，一辈子觉得你可爱，一辈子陪你，一辈子给你我的爱，我的宝贝，别再等待。